jump across maybe both nations and different roles. I'm very sensitive to the fact that the governor of São Paulo, who is in fact going to be hosting this next event in a year from now, needs to leave precisely at a certain point. So I will come to you at the right time, otherwise you'll miss your plane. But could I ask Johnny Joseph, who from the Chief Secretary of the Government of Maharashtra, to be the second to comment on these issues of governance?
Please. Richard Burritt, yeah. Daryl DeMonte, and all members of the panel and friends. Well, I will dwell 5 minutes on the three topics which were given me. That is, when you first came into office, what were the key issues facing your city, and what you felt needed to be addressed. Second is about what have been the major success stories and what are the constraints and how you would like to handle in the hindsight. I am Chief Secretary to the Government of Maharashtra for the last 4 or 5 months, but before that I was Municipal Commissioner of Mumbai. So I have first-hand knowledge of the city of Mumbai. So I propose to dwell on this aspect as far as Mumbai city is concerned, more than because running of the cities means practical handling of the city. When I first came to office about 2004, the key issues that were facing the country, the city, was about basically the infrastructural weaknesses, basic civic infrastructural weaknesses, and also inadequacies of water supply, sewerage system, and also we had problems of service delivery, problems of satisfaction of the citizens, problems of disaster management. The city in July 2005 underwent a trauma in the form of a deluge, which is well known, and I find from one of the papers the government was absent. I just want to say that government was very much there, but not seen. Therefore, when a calamity comes in the evening and you are not able to do, it is beyond you and unprecedented, never anticipated, not even expecting, what do you do? So turn to the Army, Navy, Air Force and all for help. But in the evening, the Air Force, the Navy, no one could help at that time in the night, and lakhs of people were, thousands and thousands of people were stranded on the road. That is the enduring sight of people on the middle of the road and water all around. People could not help. People could not be saved. So the first challenge was to remove that issue. That required short-term, medium-term, and long-term measures to ensure security, safety and security of the citizen. That is the basic thing to be done. And what I had to do, we understood that it is not, when it is beyond you, you have to prepare yourself for the worst. That is precisely what we have been doing. And I can assure you that as a result of the effort made, that hereafter it is not possible to fear such a site where people won't be helped. State-of-the-art rescue and relief teams have been put in place. Tie-ups with the armed forces have been made. And more than that, the long-term measures which are required. The basic problem was it showed up all the weaknesses of basic civic infrastructure, drainage, sewerage, and also that total inadequacy of being able to handle stormwater management. And very well, the Mitti River, which is wider, which is just 5 meters wide in one place. Now it is an average of 60 meters and 100 to 200 meters. Pumping sets have also been being provided now. And the central government, and it required huge investment. It required an investment of, $300 million. And I'm happy to say that during my time, project preparations were made. And also, this has been put in place. It has started, and my successor, I'm sure, is continuing the good work which we have started, the firm foundation we have laid. And Prime Minister has given that money for us, $300 million. And similarly, the JNURM, that is the Urban Renewal Mission, for that also we have made city development plans and procured the required support for water supply and sewerage projects costing $500 million. So in a matter of 3 years, we have been able to secure this, and we also put systems in place for that so that permanently these things will be addressed. And I can say for the last 2 monsoons, people have been able to, the trouble which people had to undergo is much, much less, and a situation like that will never come before, will not come hereafter. And second issue was about delivery. See, the problem was service delivery. People were always worried about the corruption. People were worried the licenses take such a long time. There was no transparency in working. I can say that the only solution will be to throw open everything. So we had conceived a system of e-governance. And e-governance where 240 services of the which has been given by the corporation, municipal corporation, will be possible to you will get it online. So this is something remarkable for which, you know, back office work had to be tremendous. And the money involved was also about 100 in crores, we call it 200 crores, that will be about $50 million. So much of amount was spent from the corporation itself so that we can have this system. And I can assure you that SAP, that is the system which is known for ERP, which is not there anywhere in India at least, and many places it's not there in Asia. So that is taking care of the e-governance, connectivity between wards, 200 odd offices have been connected between the to the headquarters, connectivity and this ERP software. With that, material management, financial management, human resources, everything has been computerized. Today, payment gateways are there, property tax or any amount, anything can be paid from the, you know, you can, if you can access the web and pay. We have an interactive portal. All these were possible because of a lot of work, effort put in, and we had a very excellent consultants in the form of Tata Consultancy Services who are doing the hand-holding, and the work is going on. And my successor who is here, Mr. Patak is here, he is continuing the good work, so that Mumbai will be definitely transforming itself into international. I would like to say is about this water supply, inadequate. Though it is not inadequate by world standard, we have about 200 liters per head, but we have to augment it because 59% of the people live in slum and 40% of, you know, water supply goes there. So therefore, we have to augment the supply, and for that also under the JNURM we could get the amount required, and the water, the work has also started. Sewerage, Mumbai is 51% sewer, Delhi I read somewhere it is 45% sewer, excuse me if it is wrong, but in order to have a total sewerage we will require about 4,000 crores, that is by 2020. And for that, the first phase, I'm glad to say, with the help of the central government under the NURM, they have sanctioned the first phase also, and that work is also going on, which will reach us up to 60% in another 2 years' time. And the remainder, the next phases will have to be taken. So the drainage, sewerage, water supply, all these projects have been taken. Similarly, the e-governance have been put in place, and more work is also required to be done to add to that, and which will also continue. Similarly, for the roads, must say the things which you find in the Mumbai city, the roads were bad, 2004, a lot of criticism. We appointed a special technical committee comprising international experts, and on their recommendation, we are now doing roads not on individual patchwork basis, but on total redesign, depending upon traffic and a host of 16 parameters which are studied by independent agencies. And that has now paid dividends in the form of another 120 kilometers of new roads have been laid in concrete, and also another 170 in case of other normal upgraded asphalt roads. And they have also given good service and proper maintenance. Earlier maintenance was only also haphazard, but now that also is being made proper maintenance systems are also being have been put into place. Then, as I mentioned earlier, this beautification of the entire city, things like Mr. Das is here. He has helped us with many. I'm happy that you got an award. But more than that, our award and recognition were there much earlier, and we have taken up the gateway through with his help. We have taken up the Gateway of India and a lot of other things. And Bhavdaji Lord Museum, which is in the pattern of Prince Albert and Victoria Museum in London, that has also been developed with the help of public-private participation. Mr. Bajaj Foundation has given a generous help. The Corporation of Mumbai, that beautiful heritage building, is being redone with the help of Abha Narayan Lamba. She is here, very much here. So many initiatives we have now started. Our idea, basic idea, is to transform Mumbai into an international city. And even for slum sanitation and all, the World Bank has appreciated our, you know, community toilet experiment. But going a step further, we have borrowed from Delhi, madam, first, you know, we had that one, the special toilets which are made in Lodhi Road and right in the airport. We can now see in our airport, their area also, beautiful area, which are being maintained very well, which is as good as any in this hotel itself or beyond that. Similarly, but what are the constraints which you feel? The problem is in democracy, we can only have what is called incremental, you know, to make an difference. Spectacular results will not come very easy. For that, you require to involve people. In what, 2 minutes more or less?
More.
Yes.
We only go one way here.
No. This problem of city of Mumbai, Mumbai lives in the slums, as you said, 59-60%. Unless this large-scale migration in search of employment, you will find that in the largest slum in Asia, that is Dharavi, which is now being going to be developed on the modern line, such areas, it is not the income. In order to, people come from all over India in search of employment, and then they occupy the places. So unless until the hinterland is developed, as you were rightly said, and also the entire rural area is developed, it is not, you can't address the problems of the city of Mumbai, which is like a small island. And for that, for the entire Mumbai metropolitan region, we have made a plan of $60 billion. I'm happy to say that the World Bank president who was here yesterday, Mr. Robert Zoellick, he has given in principle approval to our business plan for the Mumbai metropolitan region plan, which is about 4,325 square kilometers, as against 430 square kilometers of Mumbai city area. And also, we went a step further, and for the entire development of all urban areas in Maharashtra, which is 42% urbanized, and also the rural areas, we have asked put a business plan of $66.8 billion. Of course, money has to come from through various methods. World Bank is institutional finance is one. PPP model is what we are going to do. Government and all of us took together. If you work to a plan and also with commitment and dedication, we shall certainly be able to achieve this. And that will be my effort as Chief Secretary. Thank you.
Thank you very much.